Right, guys, we are right back here on Urban Today. I think we are, because I've been talking to so many other people as everybody else around me is taking selfies. We are at Java House, Acacia Place. Make sure you come and check them out. Beautiful breakfast right there. I'm alongside Maritza. We have Maurice. How do you say it again?
Maurice. Just move the lips like Maurice.
Maurice. Yes, and we're still talking about anything to do with Urban Today, Urban Television, and of course, investments. Let's begin with that. Most of us in the entertainment industry somehow really do not know how to invest our money. Either we're buying cars or we're showing up.
Look at Maritza throwing away the microphone.
Maritza, why are you throwing away the microphone?
Oh, she said she invests. What's happening, Maritza?
This is her investment.
You bring your coin, it's not
this
funny.
This is her investment. Do you do
you guys, I'm like
it's
a classic old female. I'm not going to venture out in businesses, try this and fail that. I'm going to do what I know how to do best. My investment is all it is.
It's the money maker right there.
Right here. Okay. Can I speak? Yes. Am I healthy? That's my investment.
Fantastic.
All right,
Maurice, let's talk about you.
Because you have been in the papers, first of all,
right,
for investment. You've been in all sorts of, I've seen a lot of your professional work that you do. You're always traveling. You're always working with international companies. And the fact that you've had a world tour before, I would imagine you know a lot about this business. In Uganda, let's be honest, a lot of the artists, as long as the guy has a very nice looking shoe, a very nice, looking
car.
Jacket, a car, yeah. I mean, he has made it in life. In your case, it doesn't seem like you do that. You drive a modest car, you are a simple person, you do the simple stuff on a daily basis. But I'm sure you started with this heavy investment.
Yes.
Why and how has it come for you so far?
I guess we were brought up differently. First of all, for when it comes to cars, I do not understand cars.
Yeah.
I'm really ashamed to every man.
Yeah.
I don't understand what car is.
This is
car.
So
yeah,
I don't.
That's
things
a shame.
That I don't understand.
It's
I don't understand cars. I don't understand.
I'm just saying. It's a shame.
I don't.
It's such a bad thing.
You have to tell me which car is which car.
All right.
Apart from the brand, I have to know what's a Z.
But you know a Nipsam.
Yes, I do. But this is the thing. What I've managed to do, I grew up doing a lot of business. I started as a construction worker, like a porter boy. And I would use the money to buy clothes that I would use on stage. Then I sold water from a pipe. And we'd you know, get people to give us like 500 shillings. And then we'd just keep bringing them water.
Yeah.
That inspired me to join youth organizations where I worked with Maple, Clickstar, African Youth Alliance, where we are trained by the Bill Gates Foundation. That also inspired me to grow into business. Eventually later I managed to open up my restaurant and the second restaurant in Bugolobi, the Sound Cup. But right now I'm involved in real estate. But my biggest business to date is music. What I do for my fans when I turn up and sing or when I'm in a movie acting, this is what opens all the doors. So for the other artists that don't invest, I encourage them to do so, but everybody has something, a path they prefer.
Yes.
You cannot tell someone something that doesn't make them happy. Personally, I want to drive all the... I like to drive the good cars.
Yeah.
I just need to remind myself to do such a thing.
Yeah.
But the things that I don't compromise on is how I dress, how I smell.
Yeah.
You're
okay.
You're all right.
You're good. Trust me. Me and Maritza wouldn't be this close.
But the things that I don't compromise on, where I probably spoil myself, is how I live, where I sleep, and how I eat, how I exercise, how I dress up.
Yeah.
Those I don't compromise. But it's important to be able to invest, but also spoil yourself.
Yeah.
You know, you can't be making money to just make money. Sometimes you just have to be stupid and remember that life is all about enjoying.
Sabrina, let me ask you a question. You're already in the limelight. Do you take time, of course you are, do you take time to, the way he says, and also invest in yourself? And when you say investing, when I say invest in yourself, do you take time to, you know, buy yourself clothes, to look good, take care of your skin, as opposed to just
absolutely.
Buy a new carpet?
Well, she has a nice phone. That's
absolutely
that's
no.
Sure.
Like,
and
that's
how
a
important
so
is
she can
it
take
when,
good...
you, when I say invest in yourself, especially in this kind of business? How important is it, especially for artists, or maybe radio personalities, movie actresses, and what do you invest in? Like, in case somebody doesn't understand,
yeah.
Some people say photo shoots.
Yeah.
So what do you do?
I think at the end of the day, it's if you're in this business and you are in front of people, you definitely need to invest in the way you look, 100%. Yeah. People will lie to you, I woke up like this. No, no.
Ain't nobody woke up like
we
this.
We didn't wake up like this. Exactly. So you definitely have to think about, okay, also don't break your bank just yeah. trying to look good because yeah. that's unrealistic. It's you'll be bougie and broke. What they call it?
Bougie and broke.
But broke and bougie, yes. You'll be broke and bougie. So at the end of the day, you need to spend within, you know, your means, but yeah. also make sure you look good. Like put like when the money comes in, you put your car budget aside for hair, nails, you know, facials, that car lotion that's gonna make your skin glow. You need to do that stuff because you need to look good.
Yeah.
And especially as a woman, I don't know about the guys though. Do you
I
guys spend on like specials? Okay.
Mackenzie spends yeah. on clothes.
Keep
as
telling
you
yourself
know, he
that.
He doesn't repeat.
He doesn't repeat.
He does not repeat.
When he's worn this shirt since Monday.
Yeah, well, I would be alive.
Sabrina would know because maybe she. But hey, listen, I the reason why we're even actually talking about this because yes. a lot of people actually don't. Recently, if you've been looking at the whole, like, for example, Ivan Ssemwanga, that was a very huge story,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
Had a lot of money, right? Like yeah. so much that is around. And you've seen how many people have said, I got 50K, I got 20K, I got 100K.
Yeah, from
and then, and you see all that. And then you see where he's probably, his resting place, and you see, and you know, you see all those different things. And then you look at Professor Lawrence Muchibi.
Yeah.
You look at his investments and you look at the things that they've left behind. When you look at that, it, like you sit back and you ask yourself, okay, now I need to start thinking of what I leave behind. Sweet Kid, I don't know if you guys remember Sweet Kid.
Yeah.
One of the most popular artists, I think, of the 2001 to 2008.
Mm-hmm.
This guy, in his first 2 years of doing music, bought a house, bought land and built a house in his first 2 years of doing music. And then in the fourth year, he
yeah.
jumps out of the music and he starts now organizing different types of shows. Today, he's one of the artists that is very comfortable. Raga D, you know very well Raga
yeah.
D, one of the biggest investors that we have in the music industry. The Bobby Wines of the kind and everyone, they invest in that. You've seen Maurice Curia, restaurants, everything.
Yeah.
I think the biggest problem that we have today is that you are getting into the industry, not necessarily to actually make it work financially, economically for you, but maybe because you need to have the status of saying, I made it in life. Because
mm-hmm.
there is no other job you're going to get, especially when you're an artist. You kind of get into this job thinking, it has to work out somewhere, somehow.
Yeah.
I'll sit in the studio,
yeah.
I'll wait for this PD to come and give me the job,
yeah.
I'll wait for the producer to come through. And when you get it, we're talking about this.
Yeah.
In a year, a radio presenter could make about 24 million in a whole year. If you look deep detailed into the things that you do on the side, on the
mm-hmm.
whatever, that's a regular normal radio presenter, or
yeah.
even a TV presenter,
yeah.
make about 24 million. When you look at it in detail, where is that 24
is
million
that
in December?
Do you know how disheartening that was for
me?
He ends up by telling me, because
yeah.
you know we talk about these things a lot.
Yeah.
That is what you need kind of friends like those here when you talk about finances. Then after that, he says, now, once you see it's, let's say, 12 million or 24 million, turn it into pounds. And find out how much you're earning in pounds.
Oh, wow.
I was like,
well,
and you find you find like in a year you're earning £2,000.
No, but listen, at the end of the day, I feel like no matter how much you make,
yeah.
if you are educated about things like that, you can make the right moves. However, in Uganda or in like the system that we were brought up, I don't think we have that education, if you know what I mean. Like,
should have been
we
born.
Usually,
I wish I was
most
born
of us,
in India.
Most of us are raised in households where it's paycheck to paycheck. You get what
yes,
I mean?
Yes,
there's rarely any investment, if any. So at the end of the day, you're like, okay, so where am I going to get this kind of information from? You're just like, okay, so I got paid bowling.
Yeah.
So you spend your money. You get what I mean?
Yeah.
Yes.
Roughly how much do you spend on a music video?
About 16 to 15 million.
What? Hey, comrades.
Wow.
What? Those are how many bits?
I have
a question.
You're investing in
the
your career.
Want to see something
yes,
that's
you want to
nice.
See quality.
Yeah.
So
competitive
me,
in yeah.
investment in the career.
I mean,
I'm curious. So 15, 16, where did you say?
15-16 million.
15-16 million.
Yeah.
Okay. My 4-year salary summed up in one music video. Please explain. Does this go like? Is it equipment? Is it manpower?
You see, when you're shooting a music video, there's the director's cut. How much the director gets? There's the camera guy. Mm. There's the makeup artist. There's the stylist.
Yes.
There's the dancers. There's the vixens.
There's the location. There's
the storyboard. There's the location. There's the taxes. There's the permissions to shoot in certain locations that maybe are prohibited.
Yeah.
You know, so it does take a lot to put such a video. And
but you get it back.
You kind of do if you make your calculations right. I won't lie, there's times I've invested in videos that nobody paid attention to. You know,
like, and then.
Well, more is clear. The investments you're making, we need a lot of lessons from that. Because, I mean, if you're going to be an actor, musician,
by the way,
I don't know, everything, businessman and all that, you must be doing your economics
this
right.
Guy, no, I the Beyonce's and the Jay-Z's in Uganda.
This, Didan, I've messed up so many times.
Yeah.
So it's only right that I learn from many of these things.
Yeah.
Like every other day you do something and you say, oh God, I should have listened to Mackenzie.
Oh yeah.
And he was right, and he had no idea what he was talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
But he was right.
Let me tell you, me, sometimes I hear Mackenzie say things and I'm like, tomorrow I'll do the same thing. And I'm like, damn it, he said it. Then I'm like, oh, come on.
Maurice Curie, I have another question. In the spirit of, you know, getting extra jobs on the side,
right,
as a low-earning radio presenter, TV personality, slash hashtag everything.
Investing in herself.
How much exactly do video vixens get?
Oh my, listen, don't answer that. What we're going to do, we're going to get into a short break. Video Vixens, please watch this, and then if you actually know how much you earn, send us that communication right now on Facebook. It's Urban Television, on Twitter and Instagram at Urban TV Uganda, at Kella Mackenzie, at Miss Didan, at Maurice Curia, at Maritza, at Mama KLA, and of course at Sabrina.
S-A-S-A.
Breezy. Jeez, so Sub Breezy is in here. And we also have some guys who are here. You're fasting, right? These guys are not even having breakfast. They're fasting, but they're here with us.
This is so wrong.
So they're having breakfast somehow. Eh? Wi-Fi is
all right. Yeah, Bridget fast at night. Bridget, listen, we know what you're fasting. We know.
We'll be right back.
Unavoidable circumstances.
It is Urban Today.